This conference will now be recorded.
You can go to your work center.
Okay.
Even display or change whatever.
Yeah.
WCC0. Okay. If you go to capacity.
Okay.
And excuse me.
Okay.
Okay, my question is here. The processing duration SP002, it says here production machine time. But we did not mention here production labor time. So is labor time is not necessary, or if you go to costing, we saw the both working, I mean a machine and a labor hours. If you go to costing and you can see it, the, you have a machine and labor as both, it's okay. Covered the time, discover the time, both of them. I mean, I understand, yeah. Because when you work, it will cover the machine time and the labor time. But the formula, why we put the only formula for the machine in scheduling?
Okay. Yeah.
The voice is echo here. I cannot see it.
Time and time.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
You're able to hear me? Hello?
The voice is a little echo today.
Nicholas? Nicholas, you are able to hear me?
It was a breaking. Your voice is breaking, but now you can hear me. Yes, it's better now.
Okay. Okay. Maybe some network problem. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So in scheduling, it is for the find the start date, calculating the start date and end date. Okay. For labor, it is not required to find who is starting now and who is ending, because the person, the labor who is working, he you want to monitor, you need to take separately the HR module. Okay. But here, why we are labor is only their capacity, means how many labor, and their costing, cost for labor or cost total labor. We don't require here when he is coming or when he is going in our production. If you want when he is coming and going, then you need to take HR module.
But what
the
you
scheduling
want to
means starting.
Yeah. Only for the machine.
Yeah. Scheduling is for the only machine. Scheduling man means start date and end time calculation. So that is the reason here there is no labor formula. You don't require.
And the costing, okay. He is calculating machine and labor.
Yeah.
Capacity. Yes.
Because labor cost.
Yeah.
We need to calculate what is the labor cost.
I think the capacity did something too. I don't remember any.
Yeah, capacity also will have, because how many labors? Yeah. It is nothing but.
Yeah.
The capacity is only also
if you need
doing the machine.
Yeah, yeah. 1 minute. If you need labor as a capacity.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here you can add a separate button. Here capacity is machine. You want to calculate labor also capacity. So click this button, new button, create mm-hmm. capacity.
Mm-hmm.
Here one more capacity category has come. Here you can select your
labor
is the person, labor mm-hmm. or person.
Okay.
You can select
uh-huh.
and here you can enter the, once you press enter against 3002, you can get the labor capacity.
And what about the two check marks?
Which two check marks?
In general data.
Capacity responsible.
capacity responsible is a person.
Yeah.
And capacity business unit means unit of measure.
Each.
Hour. Not each, actually, it is our time only.
Hour, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. When you create the new labor capacity, so you can leave as is, that not affects on the calculation?
Which one?
That will not affect on the whole work center?
Which one?
Okay, if you see, you added up labor
Correct.
Capacity, right?
Mm-hmm.
But my point is, the whole work center capacity is not affected. Your result will be the same.
Yeah, it won't affect for the machine hours, but it will affect for your calculation of production order start date and end times.
And it will calculate the labor too, right?
Yes. Correct.
So it means if I don't calculate the labor capacity, and you leave as was before, so
Correct.
The result will be still same. Even you calculate this, the result will be the same.
You mean to say if we add or not add also, it is same or not for
right.
mission time?
Right.
Okay. For mission time, it won't add any impact. But as
right.
a production order total time, it will affect. You need
okay.
to consider capacity also. Here, example, if you want to run a mission, okay, example, 20 hours you want to run a mission, you need a 10 labors. Okay, that is your constraint. To run your mission 24 hours, you need 10 labors. Okay, today only 5 labors has come. Okay, will you able to run the mission 24 hours? You may not. You may run only 12 hours only.
Okay.
You have the mission capacity, but you have labor constraint.
I see. So the machine
in
is
those
a
complicated cases, you need to use this labor, otherwise leave it that.
Okay. So in other words, the machine capacity is mandatory, but not the labor one.
Correct.
I see. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, machine scheduling is the most important, not the label. Label.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Any other questions?
No.
Okay. So I'm going to our regular class. So yesterday we are discussing an availability check.
Yeah.
Okay. It will check the whether components are available or not. Okay. In production order, so that practically I am going to show you now. Once again, we need to know what is our production order. Okay, so I am taking any production order. This is so, for example, this is the production order. Okay. So here you can click on the check material availability. Okay, check means we have a components, car, the tire and 166. So for these we need 550 and 220. So system will check whether these are available or not. Okay, so you can click on check availability.
Should select the line, no?
Yeah, you don't require it, will check. You can see all checked materials in order are available.
Oh, great.
Okay.
Okay.
Just
so why it has given is,
you find
can check
the
what is the stock. Yeah, you can check the stock.
MMB.
Go to MMB. Honda Tire. You have a stock 1700, so it is saying it is available. So, okay. So now, for this same, I will show you another example. Okay. For example, I am going back. For example, this total quantity is you need a cars of 110. I will put 1000.
Okay.
1000 cars. Okay, and just press enter automatically for 1000. How many tires are required? It will calculate automatically. Okay,
5000.
So now, yeah, I'm going to the components. You can see 5000 and 166 for this 2000. You need now. If I check the material availability, it will say all available or shortage.
Shortage.
Yeah, correct. Because our stock is 1700 only, we need
5300. Yeah.
Yeah. Now I am clicking this material availability check. You can see, you will get this screen. Okay. This shortage is called missing parts list. It is called the missing parts. Shortage means missing parts. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you want to see how much is the shortage. Okay. You can click this missing parts list or missing parts war. Any button you can click. Okay. Click this. So it will show you another screen here. So this will tell you. So these two materials are shortage. Which are the material shortage, it will tell you. This is actually how much is you required. Okay, and system will show you how much is there in the stock here. Okay, you can see confirmed quantity.
I see.
So that means out of 5000, you have only 1700 only. Out of 2000, you have 481. So based on this, you can either start the production or postpone the production. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. This is the purpose of checking availability in production order.
Okay, can I ask you a question? You know, in this case,
yes,
when you start the production and at the same time you order what is missing, or how it will work out? Is that right?
Sorry, come again?
I said now you said either we start the production or we stop the production.
Correct.
Okay, if we start the production, so we will order at the same time what is missing, or how it will work out?
Okay, okay. So that means actually this is availability check. If we will check before starting the production, for example, tomorrow this order needs to be started. Okay, so today we will check whether all the material is there or not. Okay,
yeah.
Now all the material is not available, so who is the responsible? MM person is the responsible. So
you
I will ask
before starting the
production.
Before starting the production,
yeah.
Now which transaction code that you referring to before you starting the production?
You can use this same CO02 change master production order. Here you can check, or you have a separate transaction codes also for checking this availability of stock. I will tell you that stock.
Availability check stock. separate decode. Okay, let's see which one is the T code for availability check.
And maybe a 250. Okay, 250 cars I can produce. Can I start the 250, or do I need to wait till all the raw materials comes?
Mm-hmm.
So that business will take the decision. Okay, and they will find why the raw material did not came. Because of the vendor problem, or because of the transport problem, or some other problem, they will identify and they will try to rectify it.
They will try
okay,
to fix
Nicholas?
It.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Let's go to see the new transaction code for availability check.
That I will tell you actually.
Yeah, today phone connection is a little rough.
Today?
I said the okay. Phone connection is breaking.
Is this
a new GoToMeeting download, or this is the that's why it's happening?
No, maybe a network problem.
I see.
Maybe a network problem. Okay, so I will show you this another transaction code later, not now, because that is nothing but a mass. I will show you mass means what are the functions we can do it. Okay, this in real time possible to check each order wise. You will check tomorrow I need to start 10 orders. So for the 10 orders, all the materials are available or not, I need to check. Okay. It is not good to check one by one order. You can do that by collective. So that collective transaction, I will explain you later.
So it okay. means you create the 10 orders and we will collectively check for the 10 orders.
Yeah.
I see.
Not only create example, I told you. Maybe
example.
Two orders, three orders, whatever.
Yes, yes.
So now I will go to another topic.
Mm-hmm.
Here. This is for the material availability check. So material is available or not?
Yes.
Okay. Like this. You need to check capacity is available or not.
Capacity available or not?
Capacity, yeah. Capacity available or not means you have a machine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Machine can produce per day, only assemble the car per day, only 100 cars.
Uh-huh.
Okay. In 24 hours, it can do only 100 cars.
Mm.
But you are created on order for 200 cars.
Okay.
Is it possible to manufacture that order?
Okay.
It is not possible.
Yes,
okay.
By for 2 days, not in the same day.
Sorry, by?
Yes, we can do, but we cannot manufacture 200 car in 24 hours. So in this case, we will do it in 48 hours, maybe.
You have only one machine. You don't have alternative machines.
Yeah, so that means we cannot do it. We cannot do it with 24 hours.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. So what you will do today is 100 cars. Tomorrow is another 100. You will plan.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. That is called the capacity planning. You need to consider your capacity also. Okay.
So one day, of course, one day you can work on 100 cars, and another day 100 cars.
Yeah.
And that's called the capacity availability.
Capacity planning.
I'm sorry? Capacity planning. Capacity planning.
That's called capacity planning. Okay.
Okay. So now, in this capacity planning, we will perform two steps. One is capacity. Before this, what is the prerequisites? What is the setup you require? Okay. To do the capacity planning, like for availability check, I told you this is a setup. You need to maintain availability check group in MRP3 tab. Okay. Same thing, you need to perform the capacity planning. First thing is, okay, capacity tab should be maintained in work center. So you should maintain tab means you should maintain a formula. And you should maintain the what is the start time and end time in this work center. Mm-hmm. Means you, if you open the work center, so the details which are there in the capacity, like formula, and you should have a this is the capacity. 14 hours is your capacity. This should be maintained and relevant to finite scheduling is maintained. It is important. Okay. This is important. Now, what is finite scheduling? What is infinite scheduling? I will tell you. The words I will tell you.
So that will be start and end time will be different?
No. Finite scheduling, infinite scheduling. Okay, finite scheduling means you have a capacity 100 and you planned 100 only. That is called the finite scheduling. Mm-hmm. So you planned and capacity should be equal or less also. You planned less. Okay. Less than or equal to your maximum capacity. That is called the finite scheduling. Okay. Infinite means you have a capacity, but you planned is more than your capacity. More than your capacity. That is called the infinite scheduling. Planned is more than capacity. Okay.
Okay.
So you should remember these two words.
Finite.
If you want to do a capacity, yeah, capacity planning, mm-hmm. your work center should be a finite scheduling. Otherwise, there is no meaning.
I see.
Your capacity planning is not correct.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So if you not selected this finite scheduling tick mark, uh-huh. system will consider this as an infinite scheduling and it will plan more than your capacity.
I see.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That is first thing. Second point here is in MRP, when you run the MRP, MD01N, in scheduling, you are selecting the scheduling button. Here, you need to select this option. Lead time scheduling and capacity plan. Okay, you must select the option second. Then only system will do the capacity. Capacity it will do, otherwise it won't do capacity. Okay, you need to select option two. You can see lead time scheduling and capacity planning.
Option two.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in MD-04, you need to select the option two while doing the scheduling.
So when we did the MRP before, I think did we select two before?
I think so. We selected two. Otherwise, we will run it once again. Okay.
I think
so now option is in MD-01N.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Select option two for scheduling.
Option.
Okay. So these two are important things.
Yeah.
Okay. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Now, what are the steps we will perform in capacity planning? First is called the capacity evaluation.
Capacity evaluation.
Yeah. What is evaluation? Evaluation means first you should know how much is your capacity of that work center and how much is overloaded or loaded on that work center.
I'm sorry, say the last part.
Yeah. For example, capacity is 100.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so how much is it planned as per after MRP run? How much is it planned? You should know first. That is called the evaluation. Whether it is planned 100 or 50 or 200 or 500, how much it is planned? That you must know. That is called the capacity evaluation. Okay, it means what is the status of your work center regarding to this capacity? Okay. You use the transaction code CM01 for this capacity evaluation. Okay. It's nothing but a check the situation of capacity on work center. Okay, so evaluation is nothing but checking of your capacity on this mission. For that we will use the transaction code CM01. Now I will show you this transaction code. So the navigation path for this is production. Capacity planning, you can see separate tab. Expand, you can see the folder evaluation. Expand and expand work center view. And this is the option CM01. Open this transaction code. This is a screen will appear here. You enter your work center here, WC001. What are the work center you want to check your capacity? You enter that work center and plant. This capacity group is not a mandatory, but enter your work center and plant. You can take the screenshot.
Yeah.
Okay. And then press enter.
Okay.
So now you can see this table, it will display. From this you can understand. Okay. This table is showing week wise. week 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, week wise. Okay. This is the requirement. Okay. Requirement means your orders, nothing but you planned this many hours of orders. Okay.
So requirement, requirements means the planned.
Correct. Planned.
Planned. Okay. Okay.
Available capacity means your available capacity on mission. Okay, so available in the week of 19, it is saying available 70 hours. How this 70 has come?
Okay, when you talk, the voice completely stop.
Yeah, okay. So I will repeat once again. So available capacity, it is showing you 70 hours. This is hours, okay, 70 hours. How this is 70 hours has come?
Yeah.
I will show you. So per day, how much is your capacity in work center?
14 hours, I think.
Yeah, 14 hours. Per week, what is your per week you will work only 5 days a week. So 14 into 5. Yeah, 70. Okay. So here you can see 14 hours is you maintain in work center capacity. Mm-hmm. So 5 days you are working. So system is showing you that is a 70. That is a called available capacity.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Wherever 56 is means you may be having the 1 day as a holiday. So now here 74% capacity load is 74%. What is that meaning is you are available 70 hours, but you loaded the orders of 52 hours only.
Mm-hmm.
That is nothing but a 74%.
I see.
You have a remaining capacity of 18 hours. Okay, so that means in 19th week you can add one more order which is having 18 hours also. Okay, based on this one you can check, you can see 16, 17, 18, there is no orders, there is no requirement. And you can see capacity load is 0%. So you can either move some of the orders to these weeks, or you can ask your sales department to give some orders. I need to, because mission is, means mission is idle. Okay.
If the machine is idle, but it's still showing 14 hours.
That is available. 2 days is 1 day is available. This is available capacity. You have a capacity, but you need the orders. Okay. So using this table, you can get what is the situation of your capacity on the mission. Okay. In this screen, we are not doing anything. Means like changing or something, we won't do, only to
for
check the status on
for the information. Yeah,
yeah, for information only. Okay. So and you want to see further details in this one, you can see, for example, 19th week, this remaining requirement are 52 hours only. What is this order number you want to see? You can select that week and click on this capacity details period wise. You can select. So it will show you on 19th week, this is the order it is. Okay. This is the order is planned. And its quantity is 100.
Okay. And what it says on the top, we say PE, pegged requirement?
Pegged requirement. Pegged requirement. Pegged requirement is nothing but your planned order.
I see.
Planned order or production orders is called the pegged requirements. Okay. So here you can check how much is loaded and everything. Okay. Is it clear this one?
Yeah. I'll go back one.
Okay.
More time, please.
Yeah. Select it and click on this button. Okay. Now, for example, so 16, 17, 18 weeks are empty. So I want to move some of the orders into these weeks. I want to move because next 3 weeks idle means it is not good. So what I can do is I will move some of the orders from future to these weeks. Okay. How can we do that?
You want to delete this three or you want to move it?
We cannot delete. These are the weeks.
Uh-huh.
We won't delete. Okay. Mission, we won't delete. Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you are keeping mission as not running, so you are losing your profits.
Mm-hmm.
Correct. You lose your profit. So how you can do is you can move the future orders to these weeks, because and you can tell to your sales or marketing team, so you bring some orders. Okay. So how you can move these orders into these weeks is that step is the second step. That is called the capacity leveling. Okay, level means you will adjust. Okay, this is called sequencing of orders. Sequencing means you can put one by one order. Okay, now let me one more thing. Okay, I'm going back. Go back. Okay, so to do that leveling, we have a separate transaction code here in the folder. You can see after evaluation, you have a button means folder leveling. Expand it, expand work center view, and this is the transaction code CM21. It's the transaction code for leveling of orders. Leveling, or it is nothing but a sequencing of orders. Okay, so I will show you how we can do this.
Yeah.
Open this transaction code. So in the selection screen, it will ask you work center and plant. And then you can click execute button.
Can you hold on 1 second?
Yeah, sorry. I'm going back 1 second.
Yeah.
OpenCM 21. This is a selection screen. Okay. Click on exit button. So now you will get a view like this.
This is look like a graphic view.
Yes, this is called the graphic view. Okay. Graphic view is divided into two parts. One is the top is work center and below is the orders. Okay. And in the work center, you will have a timelines. You can see CW 16 means week 16, week 17, week 18, 19, 20, 21. Okay, and for example, under week 17, you have a white color and gray color, white color and gray color. Wherever the white is there means that is a one day. White means one day. And that is we have the 14 hours. Okay, there is a gap from today to the next day is we are working 14 hours only. Out of 24, we are working 14 hours. So there is a gap of 10 hours. That 10 hours is nothing but this gray color. Okay.
So gray color is a gap.
Gap means not working. That time we are not working. And there is a lot of gray color, nothing but a Saturday and Sunday weekend.
Right.
Okay. So wherever the four is there, that means one day is holiday in between. Wherever five is there means it's 5 days a week. 5 days are working.
Yeah.
In this week. Okay.
Yeah.
That is in the work center area. And then below is the orders. So here you can see these are the our Honda car planned orders. Okay. Okay. And here only one planned order, but we have same on the different operations we are working. You can see 10th operation, 20 operation, 30 and 40. Okay. So these are the operations because you are doing same on the same work center, multiple operations.
Okay. Sorry, where we can see the other planet order? We have a multiple planet order, like 3, 4, 5.
Yeah. Okay. Actually, only we have only one planned order. That is the reason it is showing you.
Oh yeah, the other one we converted, was converted. Yes.
Yes, correct. You have only one planned order. You can see. Remaining all are. Right. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So I will do one thing manually. I will create one planned order. We can see it now.
Okay. Yeah, okay. And the other thing is when you were looking the work center and orders, there was a red line. What was the red line about?
Where?
In a work.
Today. Work. Maybe it is today day.
No, the can you go back to the
display work center planning. Yeah. Where is
the this red one. Color? Red color.
Yeah, that is your cursor moving.
No, the so red.
Wherever
colors.
You put your cursor.
No, I'm talking about the red 19. Yeah.
Okay, does mean this one here? You start the manufacturing, the production.
Yeah, correct. Correct. This operation, 10th operation, you are starting on this week. Okay. You can see I put the starting of that block. That means in the bottom you can see the date and time. Bottom. 05/07/2019 and the time is 10:50.
Yes, one second.
So this order is starting on that time.
Yeah.
This order and that operation is starting on that time.
I see.
okay, and ending on this time. Once the 10th operation is completed, 20 is starting. After 20 is completed,
21.
Oh,
yeah,
start.
We have to continue. Yeah, yeah,
continue. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, I will create one more planned order. We can see that also here. Okay. So to create a planned order manually, you can create. Create planned order. So here you enter the plant material and some quantity, maybe 50 quantity. And here you can enter the end date for this planned order, maybe 25th. And start date is today, and press enter. Okay, and you can save this. Oh, 1 minute. This planned order change, go to the change. Okay, this is a planned order number 5677. It is created. Okay. 5677. Okay. Now, if you go to the capacity, it will show you. It should show. So I will go back and come again here. There is no refresh button. So I am once again opening CM21, execute. No, no order. Okay. Okay. You need to click this scheduling button. Scheduling. Okay. Then system will calculate the start time and end time for all the operations. When you are creating planned order, you need to click on this scheduling order also. So then this additional tab will come, detailed scheduling, and it will show you the start date and end date for all these missions. And you can save it. Now once again I'm going to this capacity leveling. Now you can see you have, okay, you have two orders. Okay, and in this case you can see these two are overlap, correct? Is it possible to manufacture these two?
Yes, if it pass in the capacity, yes. If not, it will be infinite, not finite.
Yeah, correct. Okay.
So if it is 70 hour for both of them, it will work out.
Yeah.
But it look like, but yes, it worked. Yes, is that right?
Yeah. Generally, it won't work if we are having the two orders simultaneously. We won't manufacture. For example, car is there. Somebody want red color and black color both, so it is not possible to assemble both at a time. It should be one after one only. Okay. Yeah. So in this example, I will show you capacity evaluation also, how it looks like. Now it should show overload. You can see.
It will not work. Yes, red.
Yeah, you can see. If it is a overload, it will show you a different color.
Okay. Yeah.
So you have a 70 hours of work, but you plan 122 hours.
Yeah, it's too much.
And here 120 hours. It is too much.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is actually the one of the example where you have the overload now. In this situation, what you will do? You need to move the the overload orders to the next day only.
Yes.
Because you don't have the capacity, you cannot manufacture it.
Yes.
Jamal, is it clear?
Yes, so far.
Okay. Now I'm going to the, now how can we move that orders? I will show you. In the capacity leveling, mm-hmm. evaluation is only to check only. You cannot do. In the leveling only, you can move the orders. How you can move the orders is just very simple. You select this block, okay, and in the top there is a button dispatch. Okay, these whichever you want to make this operation one by one, you can do that. You select this, okay, select this operation or block, okay, and select this work center, select this operation and click on this dispatch button. So this order will go and sit into this work center now. Okay. Now I am manufacturing for this order first 10th operation. Which one I selected? Sorry. So 5766. 5766 order I have selected. Okay. 5766 order. 5766. This order 10th operation I selected. Okay. Now you want to do for the same order 20th operation. You can select this and again click on the dispatch button. It is dispatched. Okay. Now second operation is over. After that, you want to do 30 operation. You can select and dispatch. 40 operation. You can select and dispatch. Okay. Now all these operations are in sequence. I'll expand out. Now this is first order is over. Now you can select for the another order one by one and you can dispatch. You can either click the dispatch button or you can drag and drop also. Drag and drop means you can select this, hold on and move this cursor, drag and drop, this is called. You can drop it here. Okay. One is you can select and click the dispatch, it will go, and maybe you can drag and drop also. So we are sequencing it one after one, which is the first one, which is the second one, you are sequencing. Just a drag and drop. This is called the capacity leveling. Okay. And this is very important activity in production. Because people has to do their capacity. Otherwise, they will face a lot of problems. Okay. You can drag and drop everything. And finally, you can save it. Saves. So all the orders and operations are dispatched. Finally, you can click on save button. Yeah. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Absolutely.
Save. Yeah. Save. Now it is sequenced. Everything is sequenced. Now you can check the evaluation once again. Whether that overload is there or not.
Perfect. Now. Yeah.
Now you can see. Okay.
Oh man.
Everything is overloaded. Means capacity loaded is almost 100.
Yes. Wow.
Okay.
Great.
So this is how we need to do the capacity planning. Okay.
Okay.
So this capacity planning may be used or may not be used based on the, so for example, making, assembling a car, you will use it, but assembling an engine, it may not require. this capacity plan, because engines you are making only 10 per day, but you have a lot of capacity. 100 per day is there. Your mission capacity is 100 per day, but you only orders 10 per day, 20 per day. So that time you don't require to do the capacity plan. You have a lot of overload.
What about the other industries besides the auto industry, like some other industry?
Yeah, like, any industry. So I'm saying one example where, for example, in your family, you are only two people. Okay, you can take the car, which is having the four seats. So you don't bother about the every day. You don't require to check whether car is sufficient or not. Okay, but if you have a five members family, you have a car of only four seats. So that time you need to, every day you need to check. Okay, today only four people has to go, or who is going that four people. Okay, so these are the business scenarios based on that this capacity planning will be done. So Nicholas, you can leave. I am stopping the class here. This topic is over. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Vasu. Appreciate
thank
it.
You. Thank you. Right. Thank you. Right. Yeah.
Thanks, Jamal.
Thank
yeah,
you.
Thank you. Yeah. Jamal. Okay. Yes. So this capacity planning is may not be required for all manufacturing scenarios. Wherever it is required, it is very important to use this one.
So in other words, this could be required only in all processing means discrete and process and repeated.
Yeah,
I see. And also this will require or not require like manufacturing, autos, parts, aerospace industry, or I would say food industry, or any other industries is required.
Correct.
I see.
Correct. This is required in all these kind of industries. Okay.
Yeah.
So capacity planning, if I ask questions, means you should able to explain that. We have two steps. One is capacity evaluation and another one is capacity leveling. In evaluation, we will only know what is the situation of orders. But in capacity leveling, you will do the sequencing of orders. Okay.
Yeah, so one more time, we say capacity leveling. One is capacity evaluation, the other one is capacity
leveling. Here I
written capacity leveling. Yeah, okay. All right, capacity leveling. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So I will stop the class now. And yes, we'll do same tomorrow. Okay.
Hopefully. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.